And some of the things you highlighted, you know, you said that the first meeting, which was the one for Edo State,
yes,
you were not part of the committee that invited people. You couldn't verify whether or not the chairman was invited.
Yes.
He was not present at the meeting.
Yes.
And then the second meeting, which now included an expanded one for the South-South, you say he was invited.
The chairman who who was responsible for the invitation stated clearly to the press that he was invited.
Okay, but what about the first one? Did you find out, did you ask whether or not he was
he
invited?
He was also invited. But you know why you are going through, why we are going through this? To me, him not being present wasn't a shock to me at all. Because this is not the first time the South-South is holding his meeting. Because of his national... I'm not responsible for his schedule.
Yeah, but
where in Asaba, he was not able to attend. Where in Abuja, he was not able to attend. You are trying to make it sound like because of this endorsement, he was skillfully or indirectly kept out of the meeting. It's not true.
No, as a national chairman... Let me ask the questions myself. I know what I'm about to ask, so you can't second-guess me. But the thing about that is, you know, we've seen his response ever since then. He said, look, what happened there was childish. He said it was foolish, that because, number one, where did this meeting even hold? Where was the venue?
The venue was in government, was in Edo State, Benin City.
In government house.
Yeah, but remember...
Government house.
Yes, APC government house. But remember, that is the only APC state we have in the whole South-South zone.
Okay, part of what he said is, look, why would you hold such a meeting in government house?
Why not?
And he then said, look, votings for this kind of matters are not done at this level, that they are done at the convention level. He is saying, why rush to do all of those? Why don't you wait and come for the convention and then you vote?
It's not a question of why rush. The convention, the day of convention is when final decisions are made for the various positions. What leads to the convention is homework. People clamor, support the candidate of their choice before the convention. It is what you have done prior to convention that manifests in convention. In this case, why are you questioning government house? The governor of Edo State, Godwin Obaseki, is like a junior brother to the national chairman.
What the chairman said is, look, what he thinks happens there is that, number one, the former governor wants his job, and he says, look, the former governor was instrumental to the current governor coming on, so he thinks the meeting held in a government house was a case of rub my back, I rub your back.
Yes, I read that this morning. Let me tell you, what was instrumental for the emergence of Godwin Obaseki is the monumental achievement of comrade governor, not because comrade governor, and because comrade governor has done well. Another Chief Oyegu has also contributed immensely to the emergence of this governor. It's not a question of it was done in government house. Government house is...
Yeah, but did you expect him...
His Excellency...
So wait, you actually expected him to come for the meeting in government house when he knew that the former governor and the current governor will not be in his support?
He was in government house a few weeks ago.
There's for a meeting?
There's event he did.
That's a separate event.
I don't think it's a problem for a man you help produce as governor. You have a problem in going to government house, that is his house.
What about the senators from
there? They were there. The senator for APC.
And they were all in support of Oshoma.
And not only that, Alemi Kenna was in support. He spoke to the press. Members of the House of Representatives, Pali Iriase, the man from Akoko Edo, the Iji Agbonayima, they all spoke to the press. Every single one of them. Yeah. Speaker, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, but Mr. Manson, you said it's not a problem for all those things to have happened, but is it a problem if 4 out of 6 state party chairmen say, look, we came here for something else, and then we were ambushed to support a preconceived idea?
It's not a problem. It's not a preconceived idea either. Look, in democracy, minority can have their say, and at the end, the majority has its way.
Consider four of them minority?
Yes. If you brought together participants from 6 states, senators, caucus members, House of National Assembly, former governor, former deputy governors, and 4 or 6 or 7 over 100.
But the 100 are not from Edo State.
They don't have
to. The bigger party are not from Edo State.
Thank you very much. That's even making more legitimate. It's not a Edo State issue because we have the same number of representatives there. You have people from Bayelsa, Rivers, Cross River. The people, these four chairmen you are talking about, they are senators. Abe is from Cross, is from Rivers. He's supportive. Their senators supported the move. If, let me ask you a question. If the representative of the TV stations in Lagos are supposed to take a vote in Abuja, and the head, those, the, let's say your chairman, voted no, and you voted yes, you voted yes, you voted yes, does that nullify your own vote?
Well, we know politics is not as straightforward as that.
Well, it is, but this one was very straightforward. You see, what I must tell people,
if you were very straightforward,
let us stop this action of suspicion. I'm telling
who's suspecting who?
You know, because from, you know, politics, I'm speaking generally. I am telling you in my honor that what happened in the state is what the zone built upon. And what happened in the state was neither planned nor pushed or shoved down the people's throat. If the national chairman, for schedule reason, was not able to attend, should it surprise anyone? The man is in charge of 36 states. I don't know why he didn't come. And because he has attended before many times, and many times too, due to schedule issues, he has not been able to attend. So his absence was not something that stood out, because it's not the first time.
But this event stands out because, I mean, if in the process of reconciliation this event is happening, doesn't that further throw spanners in the works?
No, because the way you are looking at this is like they're struggling for this position. It's the, look,
are you
the
not, national, are you not struggling for
yes, the national chairmanship position is vacant.
As of now?
No, come June, when the convention, it's not vacant now.
That's why he's saying, why don't you wait until June?
Wait, no, you can't wait until June, you start campaigning. Why not tell Mr. President or the opposition party or any political party to wait till the day of election before you do your campaign? How do you win an election if you wait for the D-Day? It's like going to write an exam. You say, okay, your WAEC is on the 25th of May.
So you're not
hasty. What are you reading? What are you reading for in March?
So you're not hasty.
You have to prepare. That way you pass your exam. And this process of preparation, we held meeting, we spoke to members of like mind, and we look at the man that is being suggested.
Oh, politics.
Look at his antecedent.
Let's take it from there. Yes. When we'll come back from this break in just a moment. Don't go away. Welcome back. Well, the comment that those four state chairmen that were in that expanded South-South meeting, when they disagreed, they said that they liked the press to know that this meeting was an ambush, that it was not acceptable, and that there was no resolution. They have said that every person is free to run the polls for the position of the chairmanship come May 14.
Everybody is free. I don't think anyone has ever excluded anyone from contesting. But that was the position of Edo State Caucus and the position of the South-South. I told you before, when you call a meeting of that magnitude, with that many people in attendance, and you have maybe 5, 6, 7, 8, when you say four chairmen, give me four senators, give me four members of House of Rep, give me four members of former deputy governor, give me four members of former governor, don't give me in four, in terms as it relates to the chairman. And I respect their opinion. You know, they are not bad people. They are not bad chairmen. They probably were not prepared for the vote or psychologically.
Did they know that this was going to happen?
Look,
was it planned?
It wasn't even planned.
It wasn't on the agenda?
No, it wasn't even planned.
So it was an ambush?
No, when you say it's not the agenda, do you know the way they set up an agenda? After you finish agenda...
Well, you tell us, since you were there,
yes,
was it on the agenda?
I even came in late. It was during the final distance I came in late to this meeting. When you set agenda in a meeting, you have AOB, where every member of the those who are in attendance, as many they can be taken, will be given the opportunity to speak on issue. So, either the issue already been canvassed, or they are free to go out. And that's where you have AOB. If you just set up a meeting and you put 5, 6 people, they just come, they say what they have to say, and you've traveled far and wide, and you are not given the opportunity to contribute, what kind of meeting is that? Let me tell you, the most constructive and important decision that comes out of meeting usually comes out of AOB. Because these are people who listen attentively throughout the proceedings. And you know, when you listen more, you are able to talk more accurately on issues that have been canvassed, and you can either decide to go out of it. Again, let me remind you, this meeting was attended by over 100 persons. Four didn't like one or two things. It's allowed. Votes that are taken on the floor of Senate, you think it's always unanimous all the time?
Does it mean that the view of those four being state chairman doesn't matter, whether or not they can influence their states?
Does it mean that the view of all the seven senators from the South-South of APC, members of the House of Rep from the South-South, APC, the entire South-South caucus, former deputy governors, former governor, current governor, their views doesn't matter?
He's talking about the local level.
No, I'm talking about local level. These are the people who attended the South-South too. It wasn't attended by... You are misunderstanding this thing. We have six chairmen of the party in the South. That meeting was not attended by only six chairmen. These people I just mentioned to you, they were all in attendance. Are you now saying... I just asked a question. Former deputy governor, current governor, current senators, former senator, the APC caucus of the South-South, the APC South-South chairman, are you now saying over 170 persons' view should be thrown out?
All for
because
Shomale.
All for four. Yeah, they were all for Shomale.
All right.
They were all for Shomale. So let me quickly make this point. Those brothers that voted against, that expressed this concern, they have the right to do it.
All right.
We have no problem with them at all.
Let's talk about that point.
Majority supported the program.
All right, Lucky Master, as a former deputy governor of Edo State, thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you very much for having me.
Well, that's the show today. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you tomorrow. I'm Chamberlain Usta.
Bye for now. I'm Gimba Umar.
Opinions expressed by guests on this program are those of the maker and do not necessarily reflect the views, opinions, and endorsement of Channels Television.